Hello, I'm Ken Rickvalsky, National Product Engineer for McWane Ductile. On this edition of Iron Strong, we're going to walk through the creation of a Mill Cert and outline their use in our industry. With me today is Chad Monson, the Quality Assurance Manager for McWane Ductile here in Provo, Utah. So Chad, it's a common occurrence that some contractor, an engineer, a state agency, a DOT, will ask for proof that every single pipe we deliver to them meets or exceeds not only AWA standards, but their project specifications. Walk me through how we go about doing that. Where does it start?
Well, it all starts right here with the sticker and with the markings that we cast inside the pipe bell itself. We've got everything on here from the pipe size, class, joint, cast manufacturing date, the lining date, type of lining that's in it, and any paint or seal coat that may be inside and outside this pipe. That's where it all begins.
So Chad, what you're telling me is from this sticker and the markings in the bell, we can create a complete and verifiable affidavit of compliance, often called a Mill certification, or Mill Cert for short.
Yep. Say that three times fast, I dare you.
Mill Cert for short. Mill Cert for short. Mill Cert for short. You happy now?
Very.
Walk through this with me piece by piece. I'll point to something. You tell me what it
is.
Sure. MFG.
So that's the manufacturing date, the date the pipe was actually cast.
So when the iron went in the mold,
yep.
Nice and hot. Okay. CP.
That is the cast period. That is when during that day that piece of pipe was made.
And how many casting periods would there be in a day?
So we can break it down. We can do it by half hours. We can do it in 3-hour blocks. It depends on what the customer would like us to do.
Okay. So how many pipes might be in a half hour casting period in the foundry?
Depending on the machine it comes off of, you could have 30 pieces that come off of one of our high-speed machines.
So you're keeping the group small in case there's a problem.
Correct.
Good plan. Now what's this alphabet soup? I see it on all the pipes and I just...
So each of our pipe has a unique serial ID number. This allows us to track any rework or help us track down exactly what that pipe's gone through.
So that unique serial code can take this pipe's history fully through.
Correct.
Okay. And the other stuff looks pretty basic. 18-inch, class 50, joint arrangement, company.
Correct.
Right?
Yep.
Very good. Thank you.
Thank you.
But I hate to be that guy, but I have to be. How do I know that this sticker right here was specifically and individually made for this pipe? How do I know you just don't willy-nilly have a bunch of stickers start slapping on pipe and say, there you go?
Well, since you are that guy, come on, I'll show you how.
All right. Okay, Chad, so you've taken me to the exit end of the hydrostatic test press. Hot metal castings up there, finishing starts here.
Correct.
Okay. I see pipe flowing in and a lot of writing going on. Help me understand that.
So this is where our alphabet soup serial ID number is assigned to each piece of pipe. We weigh the pipe, he assigns which casting machine it came from, and writes that serial ID number on that piece of pipe to give
where
us the traceability. So the computer automatically assigns it as it records the weight. We already have the size and ID assigned to each casting machine, so we know what the size and class is that it's producing that day.
The code he wrote on there is the alphabet soup that we saw on the sticker.
That's correct.
Perfect. I get it now. Okay, Chad, the single most important verification for the mill certification is quality of the iron, the chemistry, the impact resistance, the strength of the material itself.
Right.
Tell me how we get those numbers.
Okay, so this is our physical testing lab, physical properties lab. We do the Charpie impact testing where we break samples. Around the corner here, we've got our tensile testing machine that gives us our ultimate strength, yield strength, elongation. We test for hardness. We've got the microscope where we'll check the microstructure, look for nodularity, our nodule count. We input all of these things into the computer so it can go on that mill certification.
Right. And we do all this sampling at a rate equal to or greater than required by the AWWA.
Correct.
Standard.
Roughly four times as great as what the standard requires.
So we keep batches of inspection very small and controllable.
That's correct. So it matches that cast period on the sticker.
So a sample result covers the entire casting period, maybe 15 or 20 pipe representative in that casting period.
Correct.
Sounds fantastic. Okay, Chad, so here we are about halfway down the finish line. The pipe has come out of cement lining, and I still see the outfit coat on the outside of the pipe and other manufacturing information. But it looks to me that the pipe is just about to get painted right over there.
That's correct.
So aren't we going to lose all this identification?
After they're painted, you won't see them anymore. So at this point in the process, after the cement lined, they're all the same size, same class. They're ready to be bundled after they're painted. So this is where we take that serial ID number, we enter it back in the computer, and at this point, they all stay in the same sequence. We don't get them out of sequence. No pipe jumps over or falls behind another piece. So we can make sure and ensure that each of those stickers goes on the right, correct piece of pipe.
So right here, right now, is where this pipe gets its sticker assigned to it.
Correct. With the lining thickness and what paint it's going to get.
All right, Chad, so here we are back at the bundling station. I've seen a bunch of stickers are flying out of here fast and furious. What'll happen next?
All right, so now we're ready to apply these stickers. We've walked through the process. We've seen how we keep things in sequence, so we ensure that they go on the correct pipe. This is where we'll actually print the labels out and apply them to each piece of pipe on the bundle.
Okay, Chad, so you've talked a lot about sequencing and the importance of making sure everything stays in the exact order from the time of assignment of the sticker number or serial number to here. So I'm going to presume that's why he started applying the stickers at the lowest foremost pipe in his bundle.
Correct.
That would have been the first pipe to come off the line all the way up to the last to make his bundle.
That's correct. He'll start at the first one, work his way up each layer, starting at the bottom, working his way to the top. So he starts at the first one, works his way to the last piece of pipe. We've also got on these labels a sequence number or the pipe number in that bundle. Each in the bottom right corner, we've got which pipe number that is in the bundle. So this is pipe number 40, number 42, down here 14, 28.
Here at McWane Ductile, we take great pride in manufacturing the highest quality of ductile iron pipe and fittings. We are equally dedicated to doing it safely and friendly to the environment, both inside and outside of our plants. McWane Ductile is a proven leader in building iron-strong utilities for generations, clean and safe. It's not just a slogan, it's the core principle of the McWane way. For more information on today's topic or anything to do with any of your utilities, contact your local regional or national engineer with McWane Ductile. Their names and addresses can be found on our website. This has been Iron Strong, and remember, in everything you do, work hard, work smart, and work safe.